Hey everyone, Matt from TOTALmtg here, and today I've got another War of the Spark pre-release pack to unbox for you. So today's one's going to be a little bit different to the first video. If you haven't seen that, make sure you go and check it out. There'll be links everywhere and it'll be on the page as well. So make sure you go and check that out. I'm sorry I forgot to flip over the promo. Don't worry, this time I will. I just did not know there was two promos. Total Wally, without a doubt. But lots of people did remind me in the comments, so that's all good. So this time I will not forget. So I'm just going to open these packs. This is more of a pack opening one. And what I'd like to see is, what would you build? So take note of all the cards that I'll be opening up and let me know which way you would have gone if you've got this pre-release pack. If you had got this pre-release pack and how you would have built it, and hopefully we get lots of nice rares. I'm looking for a bonus. I've been playing with that one on Arena and it looks absolutely amazing. So let's open this pre-release pack. I've got rid of the plastic first so it didn't take me ages to open on stream. Here we go. So what do we have? See, I can flip it over on this one. We've got an Ajani the Great Hearted. This seems pretty cool. Four mana, comes with five loyalty. This, I've been playing with this on Arena and it's been pretty sweet. Mainly on the draft and the sealed. I'm not sure what it's going to be like in constructed, but in sealed it's absolutely bonkers. The plus one, gain three life. The minus two, putting counters on, is just really, really good. And if you can get something with proliferates, you're putting things on your amass creatures and then proliferating and getting it back on top of this one is pretty strong. Limited, very strong. Constructed, let me know what you think. And this time, I'm actually flipping over. Here we go. Plain wide celebration. Choose four. You may choose the same mode more than once. So you get to create a token for 2/2 token. Return target permanent card from your graveyard to your hand. Proliferate or gain four life. And you can do this four times. That seems pretty cool. Very expensive, costing seven. Maybe EDH bound that card, but Ajani is very nice. So that is one card that you could potentially put into your deck that you might be able to build out of these packs. So get a nice little red dice. Six packs here. You know what you get in the pre-release. Six packs. Let's open them up and hopefully pull something cool. Bonus would be very nice for me. Just from a personal point of view. So let's have a look. We got a Topple the Statue. Tap target permanent. It's an artifact, destroy it, draw a card. This is not too bad a card. I know a friend of mine, Savantia, really likes this card. He's going to put it into a Taxis sort of deck. Sorin's Thirst. Then you got Relentless Advance, which is a mass three. That's not too bad. I've been playing that a lot in Limited, as well as this one, Loxodon Sergeant. We've also then got a Spark Reaper. Absolutely love the art on that card. Look at that. That is absolutely amazing. Holding him up by his throat. Absolutely lovely. Then we've got one of the wolves. Heartfire. Four damage by sacking a creature. You don't really want to sack your planeswalkers probably, but sacking a creature, absolutely brilliant. But if it does get the job done, sack that planeswalker and get the win. Enforcer Griffin. Kazmina Transmutation. Nice bit. I mean, this will shrink down anything big when you're planning drafts or sealed or anything like that. It's for two mana and blue. It's a very nice card. Toll of the Invasion. Then we got Mawu, a Loyal Companion. First of the Uncommons. Death Sprout. Destroy target creature. Search your life for a basic land card. Four mana. I mean, it's nice. It's in those colours where you can, you know, instant speed. Nice bit of removal. Get to destroy any creature and then get a land onto the battlefield. That's pretty nice. Narset, love Narset, Parter of Wales. I like that, Parter of Wales. It's such a good card. And we get God Eternal Kefnet. I am, well, it's blue. You know I'm going to love it. I will be playing this constructed. And it's a great card to have in your sealed pool as well. So would you be putting this in your deck? It's definitely, you got Narset there as well. You've got some pretty cool blue cards. That is a very nice, well, first pack. Very impressed with that first pack. Get on to the second pack. What have we got? So you got a Samet Sprint there, good with any aggro sort of deck. Arboreal Grazer, I quite like this. 0/3, enters the battlefield, you may put a land card from your hand, so potentially it's going to be, you know, it's land ramp. I like that. You'll see that in a future deck coming very soon on the channel, so make sure you subscribe. I've got lots of War of the Spark decks ready made to do gameplay videos for you all, so hit that sub button now. Joe's Greeting. Rising Populace. You know, if you want to pause this and, you know, make actually put the deck in there with a link, you can do that as well. Be very impressed if anyone does that. Bond of Discipline. Vizier of the Scorpion. We get a Jaya, a nice red planeswalker. And we get, oh, I like this card. This is Tolsimir, Friend to Wolves. When it enters the battlefield, create a Void of Friend to the Wolves, a legendary 3/3 green and white token. Enters the battlefield, you gain 3 life and you can fight another creature. Ways that you'll see in a future deck of mine. Blinking, this is actually quite fun. Killing creatures and getting more tokens. Really nice card. And it does go very well, probably with a Jarny. So that's a nice card to build around as well. Actually, before I'm going to get onto the next pack, let me put my rares out in front, because otherwise you won't know what we're doing. So, just wanted to get the rares out in front there so you know what's coming. We're getting into this next pack now. I had pre-started opening it. Here we go. Okay. So, Warsdale Crocodile, Hexproof 5/3. This is, you know, this is nice, definitely in limited. Green colours, very nice as well. Perhaps go well with your green-white deck that you might be wanting to build out of this sealed pool. Sarkhan's Catharsis. Turret Ogre. Turret Ogre, even. I'm going to butcher some of these names trying to look through the camera. Martyr for the Cause. Ashiok's Skulker. Then we got Vraska's Finisher. Is it a finisher? I mean, enters the battlefield, destroy target creature or planeswalker opponent because it was dealt damage. This is pretty nice if your little 1-1 does a little bit of damage to a huge creature and then comes in and just destroys it. There's another wolf. Dovin's Veto. Very nice. This spell can't be counter-target non-creature spell. I do like that. Gideon's Triumph as well is a nice little bit of removal. Target opponent sacrifices a creature. Eternal Taskmaster, and then our rare is, whoa, we've got Gideon Blackbeard. Well, we're definitely going white. I think now we've pulled Gideon with a Jarny as well. Green white seems very good to me. Oh, this is an absolutely epic card. Probably one of the most expensive cards in the set, I think, because three mana planeswalkers is pretty bonkers. Comes with 4 loyalty as well. The card is absolutely brilliant, and that is an absolutely epic pull. Wow, I thought the first pre-release kit box open was good. This one's turning to potentially be better. So, here we go. So we got a No Escape, Iron Bully. Then we got Crow Stringer. The Death Touch with 2/2, very strong in limited because it'll trade with anything and basically kill anything as well. So that's a very nice card. Battlefield Promotion, Stealth Mission. Lots of pump effects in this, but you've got stuff that, you know, when there's aggro decks and when you're putting these pumps in them, they get counters that stay. A bit like the old prowess decks, we say, but, you know, but these ones where the counters do stay rather than just till end of turn. So, Tyrant Scorn is nice removal in Dimir colours. Nissa's Triumph goes well into the green-white deck. And Bond of Passion is there, and our rare is Tamiyo. We've got another great Planeswalker. Well, this kit is absolutely amazing. Temur, Collector of Trails. Spells and abilities your opponents control can't cause you to discard cards or sacrifice permanents. I like that. Choose a non-land card name, reveal the top 4 cards you library, put all cards with the chosen name among it into your hand, and the rest into your graveyard. And the -3 is return target card from a graveyard to your hand. So even if you get it wrong, you get it back to your hand, return it to your graveyard. Temur, very nice. Planeswalker City, this is loving it. This is a nice pre-release kit. So, Invading Manticore. How are you building your deck? Are you writing down notes? Probably not. But are you seeing which ones you want to put into your deck? Have you got some kind of idea? Me, personally, I'm pretty much stuck on the green-white plan because it seems very strong. Divine Arrow. Nice removal in limited. Divine Arrow. That is an auto-include for me. So, we're going to get to our first uncommon, which is Invade the City. Get to amass loads, goes well in a spells matter sort of deck. Rescue a Sphinx is our next uncommon. Then we get Kiora. Someone loved this one. I remember they put it in when I was doing my top 5 uncommon and said, you missed out, Kiora. And then we have Awakening of Vitu Ghazi. Put 9/11 counters on a target land. It becomes a legendary 0/0 elemental creature. It's still a land, but for 5 mana, it becomes an absolutely huge creature. That seems pretty decent. And I get a foil Rescuer of the Sphinx as well. So, yeah, I'm green-white. Don't care what anyone says. That is the deck that I would build. So let's get into focus. There we go. That was quick today. Sorin's Thirst. Relentless Advance. This is the last pack. Warsdale Crocodile. I am going to be streaming more on Twitch as well, just to let you all know. This is a good time to let everyone know. So make sure you go and follow. There's a link below. Go and follow TOTALmtg on Twitch as well. Get across the multiple platforms. We've got Chandra's Triumph there as our first uncommon. Then we've got Elite Guildmage, 2/3 Flyer, enter battlefield, gain 3 life and draw a card. That's a pretty sweet card. We get Davriel. Definitely going to be building around Davriel. And our rare is Widespread Brutality. Amass 2, then the army you amass deals damage equal to its power to each non-army creature. Great in an amass deck. Get this in there. That is our final rare. So, the packs were pretty sweet. Got a Gideon, very happy about that. Got an Ajani. We got some nice green cards there. We got a very strong Kefnet as well. But I think with Tolsimir, Ajani, and Gideon, for me, it's definitely going to be a green-white deck. After looking at the cards, what do you think you would build? Would you go down this same sort of route? I know, you know, I tried not to go through the cards too quickly, so you did get to see them all. So if you want to, just for a bit of fun, put in there what type of deck you go for and which one you would play. I hope you've all had cracking pre-releases. I hope you've pulled absolute bombs and let me know how you did. I've just come back from Magic Fest London, so anyone I did meet there, it was great to meet you. I had so much fun. Anyway, I will see you on the next video. We'll be in a couple of days, do videos every other day. Take care, and I'll see you on the next video.